The roles are similar kind of designation, right, that we have in our life, right? What user can do what role can do what, right? So when I talk about role in IAM, right, अगर आप यहाँ पे एक डेफिनेशन देख रहे हो ना, आई एम रोल आर द सिक्योर वे टू ग्रांट परमिशन टू इंटाइटीज दैट यू ट्रस्ट. इट सेज वट एवर द इंटाइटीज यू हैव, दिस इज द वे टू गिविंग दम अ सिक्योर एक्सेस, राइट. अब मैं बात जब सिक्योर एक्सेस की करता हूँ, तो वट इज दैट सिक्योर एक्सेस? वन आई टॉक अबाउट इंटाइटीज, वट आर दोड इंटाइटीज, राइट. नाउ आई गो टू माई S3, आई गो टू माई ECT, आई गो टू माई लैम्डा, आई हैव अ हेल ऑफ सर्विसेज इन द AWS गाइस, राइट. बट एंड आई कैन कॉल दम इंटाइटीज, राइट, इजंट इट? सो लेट्स से आई वॉन्ट टू गिव दिस EC2 इंस्टेंस टू एक्सेस दिस S3 इन अ सिक्योर एंड ट्रस्ट वर्दी वे. हाउ कैन आई डू इट? कैन आई यूज रोल? यस, आई कैन यूज रोल गाइज फॉर दिस, राइट. सो हाउ दिस रोल कैन हेल्प अस, राइट? हाउ दिस इज गोइंग टू हेल्प अस? सो इन दिस केस, इफ वी आर गोइंग रोल, राइट, अगर आपने देखा होगा, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू एक्सेस द S3 बकेट, राइट, यू हैव टू गिव द यूजर एंड पासवर्ड एंड एवरीथिंग, राइट. बट इफ यू आर गोइंग टू यूज S3, यू नो, रोल्स, देन राइट, टू एक्सेस दोज एंटिटीज यू डू नॉट हैव टू गिव यूजर एंड पासवर्ड, राइट. द रोल विल बी असाइन टू योर सर्विस एंड वेन एवर यू आर ट्राइंग टू एक्सेस दोज एंटिटीज, राइट, इट विल बी एक्सेस्ड इन द ट्रस्टेड वे. दैट मीन्स कि आपको और यूजर आईडी पासवर्ड डालने की जरूरत नहीं है. इट विल यू नो फेच द यूजर आईडी एंड पासवर्ड फ्रॉम द मेटा डेटा इटसेल्फ, राइट. अगर आप दूसरा देखोगे, आई एम यूजर इन अनदर अकाउंट, राइट, एप्लीकेशन कोड रनिंग ऑन EC2 इंस्टेंस दैट नीड टू परफॉर्म एक्शन ऑन AWS रिसोर्सेज. कोई भी कोड कह रहा है कि हमारा EC2 इंस्टेंस में चल रहा है, बट ऐसे कोई भी रिसोर्सेज एक्सेस करना है, S3 करना है, EFS करना है, राइट, एथिना करना है, कुछ भी करना है, राइट. तो आई वॉन्ट देम टू एक्सेस इट इन अ सिक्योर वे विदाउट प्रॉम्प्टिंग फॉर पासवर्ड, विदाउट पुटिंग एनी पासवर्ड. इन AWS सर्विस दैट नीड्स टू एक्ट ऑन रिसोर्सेज इन योर अकाउंट टू प्रोवाइड इट्स फीचर, राइट. द यूजर्स फ्रॉम द कॉर्पोरेट डायरेक्टरी हु यूज आइडेंटिटी फेडरेशन विद SAML, राइट. द आई एम रोल्स इश्यू की आर वैलिड फ्रॉम द शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन, मेकिंग दैम अ मोर सिक्योर वे टू ग्रांट एक्सेस. मेकिंग सेंस टू यू गाइज आर नॉट? यस और नो?
यस सर,
आई ट्राई टू क्विकली री एक्सप्लेन इट. ओके, लेट लेट मी क्विकली टेल यू अगेन इट. सो फार अगर आपको पता है कि इफ यू आर एक्सेसिंग एनी ऑफ सर्विस, राइट, विल हैव टू गिव आर यूजर क्रेडेंशियल देयर, राइट. बट इफ यू हैव क्रिएटेड रोल्स, राइट, लेट्स से आपके एक EC2 इंस्टेंस पे कोई भी आपकी एक एप्लीकेशन चल रही है, बट दैट एप्लीकेशन वॉन्ट्स टू एक्सेस द डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशंस, राइट, डिफरेंट सर्विसेज, राइट. सो इफ यू हैव क्रिएटेड रोल एंड असाइन इट टू EC2, राइट, देन EC इट यू नो विद यूजिंग दैट रोल सिक्योरली वी विल बी एबल टू एक्सेस दोज रिसोर्सेज. एंड इफ यू सी हियर, राइट, द AWS सर्विस दैट नीड्स टू एक्ट ऑन रिसोर्सेज इन योर अकाउंट टू प्रोवाइड इट्स फीचर, दैट्स हाउ वी आर यूजिंग. We are getting noise from your end, guys. Can you mute? Okay. So let's go ahead and create one role, let's say first, to understand it more. Right? Let me go to roles and click on create role. Right? And what role now you are going to create? Choose a use case. Right? The common use case. You are going to set it for a EC2 to call AWS services on behalf. Yes, I will say I want EC2 instance to access the services on behalf. आप समझ में आ रहा होगा, राइट? EC2 allow instance to call EC2 services on behalf. Right? I say okay. Or you can also select these all services here. I'll click on add permission. Right? what permission this role should have, I will call it S3. Let's say now I'm giving full access to S3 at this moment, right? And we'll add one tag here. Let's say I'm gonna give it name S3 testing. Oh, sorry, I am role testing. Whatever it is. Click on review. I would call it S3 role. I will call it custom also, right? So what it will do is allow each instance to call S3 on behalf. Right, so we'll get down now, right, and we'll create this role. Right, the role has been created successfully, guys. Right, so let me go to EC2 instance now. I have not added any role at this moment, right? I'll show you by both the way, right, so that you could understand it easily. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to install AWS CLI install as well. So let's take this here also, right? So I'm going to create two machines here. I would say AWS, I will install the CLI also on Linux, so that's what I am following the tab also meanwhile, right? Because I'll need this here. Okay, I'll launch one machine here, one with role and one without role. Okay, come down now, click on select. Click on next. Right, instance is one. Let's take it in the default at this moment. So I'm taking default thing at this moment. I'm not going to enable and add anything. We'll go with the default thing. I will call it name without IAM. Configure security group. You already know everything, so I'll not explain it more. Click on review, click on launch, and select the my existing key here. I'm done here, guys, right? So I'm gonna launch one another instance, go there again, launch one another instance, drag it down now, select Linux machine here, click on configure instance. Now the time for me to add one IAM role. So click here for IAM role and select your, you know, the IAM role you have created, because I have the only one role. That's what it is coming here, right? So click on add. Add one tag here. Name, I will call it IAM. Go ahead and select the default. Everything is open for this. Will be a launch, launch, and select your key. Focus more on security group, guys, also, right? So that you do not make mistakes while we are working in drawers. So let's go there now. Alright, I gotta follow one document also. I don't remember everything. Access S3 bucket from EC2 instance with I need CLI, right? Okay, so let's open one and two document and hopefully get something good. Okay. Okay, I think we should follow this one. We'll see that, right? I will close it now. We'll follow one document here. Right? Now hopefully my instance would have been running. So let's click here and see the things. Right, first go with without IAM role. Copy it. Go to putty.exe. Is my key? It was DevOps one, right? This works. Thank God. Right, this is working now. What I'm going to do is I'm quickly going to install the AWS CLI here, because to access, you know, this I will need the CLI, right? So I'll quickly copy this. Right, what this is doing is you are going to install it in the Linux, so you just have to do curl. This is downloading this zip, this is unzipping this zip and running the install here, right? You can also curl some, you know, tar here, download the installation file by the following way also, and write and follow these instructions here, right? So that's totally up to you how you want to do it. The another way is also AWS CLI version 2 zip if you want to update it. There are two way, there will be some more way of doing this. So if one doesn't work, you can use the two, right? So at this moment I'm gonna use this itself. Okay. Alright, so the first step it says download it. Let's go ahead and I will call it mkdir-aws. Let's do curl here. So the next command is, once you have downloaded it, unzip it. Okay, unzip is not available, so I'll have to install it. Right, once you have unzipped it, you just need to install it, right? So now if you do ls-ltr, you will see one AWS directory is there, right? There is one script which is called the install, so you can run it /install. So what it will do is, you will, once you have done this, by default it will move it to the usr local so that it will be accessible to everyone, right? Otherwise you can also run this and, you know, and keep these files, I mean these script AWS CLI to these location too. Right, let's see if this works here. Now you can see the AWS is working for me, right? So the first things for me to check whether I am able to access my bucket from here और आई वांट टू क्रिएट वन बकेट हियर लेट्स से. It says it's unable to, you know, get the credential, right? Let's go to the another machine which we have with IAM roles. Right, go here. You can also verify the IAM role. You can go to edit, instance setting. You will see some IAM here roles. You can edit these rules. You can remove these rules. You can add, create more rules here. I'll remove it right. So let's log into that now. Let's log into this IAM role. Open it, right, and access it. Right. So again, I'm gonna run these commands only here, right? I'm gonna curl it. That you already know. We need. Unzip there also. Let's install the unzip and then I am going to extract it. So this. Let's put it in some another directory. So this is the instance which has IAM role, right? I am going to go AWS, right? I am going to download it now. I will quickly unzip it. AWS. Right, now you can go to this directly and run this installer. Also remember something, sometimes if your commands are not running, make sure you are moving this script to these paths also and making some soft links. So let's check the AWS, that's working for me now, right? This is the instance which has S3 IAM role assigned. Let me change the appearance bit. Right, and now let me do something. Let me try to run some commands here. So I will call it test 0034. Right, you can see the make bucket command has been successfully run here. Right, now if you go to your AWS instance, right, and go to the S3 section and see if something is happening there. Do you see guys now how the bucket has been created? But do you believe I didn't assign anything to it? I didn't, this was just my instance, right? But it has IAM role assigned. So what it did is, when as soon as I run the command here, right, it checked for the roles, right, and fetch the data, you know, user ID and password from the metadata, and log, you know, and created my bucket here, right? In the same way, like you can let's say AWS LS S3, sorry, it's S3 LS, right? You can list the bucket here also. This is the bucket, this is the time when it was created. You can just upload, download everything from here, you know, the data to the S3 bucket from here. But if I run the same command in the other other VM where we do not have role assigned, so you can see it will not provide you anything. It will ask you for the credential stuff. This is how role works. This is how role can help you. When one service of AWS would like to access the another service of AWS in a secure way without exposing anything, so the role can help you. This is call the roles.